Today, on Warrior Update, preschoolers learn online, we look behind the scenes of the spring musical, and Jason Stipp tries the tuba. It's Friday, May 1st, I'm Alenzi France, and this is Warrior Update. The Spring Musical is a team effort, one that was cut short last month. Maggie Cornetta has this story.
When the state of Illinois extended the stay-at-home order, schools were canceled for the remainder of the year, also creating cancellations, such as Waubonsie Valley's presentation of The Addams Family.
I actually had a couple Zoom rehearsals with my cast, trying to hold out hope, and we were willing to do anything, whether it meant pushing it at the end of May or doing a one performance sometime in May before, that's if we came back.
This decision was made district wide, but the directors were really supportive through it. Like, they sent a letter so we didn't have to see it from the district, and they were just really supportive, which I think is important.
Calvert says that the selection of the show is a lengthy process that is decided on by a team of faculty and staff. On the business end, the musical is an expensive endeavor that the ticket buyer may not realize. Among other things, the royalty fees for the show.
Anytime that you do a show, whether it's a fall play or a musical, you have to pay the royalties. And royalties are basically paying money to the author and the production company, and you're basically loaning that script. So with Addams Family, because you have the scripts, you also have all the vocal parts, you also have all the orchestra and instrumental parts, and then you have piano books. You have a lot going on there. So usually royalties are anywhere from $4,000 to $6,000. Usually you're looking at a tech budget anywhere between $1,500 and $2,000. We just did Wedding Singer last year, and that budget was almost $2,000 for just the costumes. Anywhere between $10,000 and $15,000 is what we spend on a musical every year.
Calvert says, ultimately, it's all about the experience for the students and making a good product. And despite the outcome of this spring, students held their heads up high.
We still had the Zooms together and big cast rehearsals together. So we still got some part of the experience, which I think is the best part, hanging out with my friends at rehearsal, and it's what I love. So I had the experience, and even though the performance was not able to happen, I still worked really hard and I still had a lot of fun at rehearsals.
Our group me that we have for our musical, it just started exploding with all the thanks and appreciation and gratitude, and everybody said that even though we had a few rehearsals, they really just enjoyed the process, and they were wishing all the seniors the best. So, I mean, everybody just came out with a lot of support.
For Warrior Update, I'm Maggie Cornetta.
Waubonsie's Planetarium is in its 44th school year. Rosie Schrader takes us inside the dome.
Opened in 1975, the Planetarium is a well-known fixture to Waubonsie Valley's landscape. The Planetarium is open to field trips consisting of K through 12 groups, from both inside and outside of Indian Prairie School District. The Planetarium also hosts scout groups and family nights for the public. In the center of the Planetarium is a gigantic Minolta series projector, affectionately referred to as Big Blue Guy.
The star projector projects just like a video projector projects a video screen. The star projector projects the stars all the way across the dome. So while you're in the planetarium, you can see both day and night thanks to the star projector. Big Blue Guy, he is original to Waubonsie Valley, so this is his 44th school year as well. His sky is very real looking. So I always get the oohs and the ahs when the lights go down and we look at the dark sky because it looks so phenomenal.
In addition to Waubonsie Valley's science courses, the planetarium schedule is packed with field trips throughout the year.
I really love first grade. because they're so inspired and so energetic and so happy to be in the planetarium. I really like sixth grade because of the contents, looking at light and how we see different things in our universe. But I really also enjoy my cosmic journey classes, my juniors and seniors, because I can go beyond what I do for the elementary and middle school, and we can really utilize the star projector at its best.
And the most common question she gets from field trip goers?
What my favorite planet is, and I always tell them the Earth.
For Warrior Update, I'm Rosie Schrader.
High schoolers aren't the only ones who are learning online. Angela Wellman reports.
Waubonsie teachers have had to adapt to teaching high school students electronically. Now imagine high school students having to teach preschoolers, which is what the Early Childhood Teaching Lab is learning how to do.
It was pretty chaotic, and all of the teachers at the same time would go, "Oh, hi," and to whichever preschooler it was, and you'd see their face light up because you remembered their name and stuff like that. And it was really just a positive experience. I knew that I'd like it, but I liked it more than I had expected.
They were so excited. They would not stop talking. They were trying to tell us everything they learned and picked up over the break, trying to fill us in. And they were excited to see each other as well. They just would not stop talking about their break. They were so happy.
Students have had to condense curriculum into something preschoolers can learn online.
Well, instead of teaching a normal class period amount of time, we have to teach in 20 minutes. And our activity has to be like something that they can do, so not worksheets or anything anymore. So like Simon Says and like reading books.
We had our Chromebook pulled up while we were on the Zoom on our phone, and we were kind of reading along. We switched off. Each teacher would read a different page. And then after we finished reading it, we asked the preschoolers a couple questions to make sure they comprehended it.
It's a difficult time for students, especially seniors, because they're missing so much of the school experience, both in and out of the classroom.
I miss the preschoolers a lot, and I'm very actively involved in the special education department, like Best Buddies and Special Olympics and stuff like that. And I just miss the environment of feeling like one. When we're like doing Zoom classes and e-learning, I feel like we don't have a big connection together and we don't feel as united. So I just kind of miss that like contact with other people.
I miss all my friends and my teachers, Mr. Stipp in the hallways. And I just miss like the things that made me smile, like the preschoolers coming in and just make my day. I just don't get to see that anymore.
I am so happy that I was able to be a warrior for 4 years of my life. And the thing I'm going to miss most about Waubonsie is probably Stipp and the student body that is full of spirit and high energy all the time. And football games are so much fun and all that stuff. I'm just really going to miss the extracurriculars and the people.
For Warrior Update, I'm Angela Wellman.
Mr. Duker, how are you?
Oh, what's up, Mr. Stipp?
I'm here to play an instrument.
Oh!
I'm trying to experience different things that I've never experienced here at Waubonsie.
Let me see if I've got... Oh, I have an extra mouthpiece right here.
Oh, nice. Perfect.
Yeah. You want to lift?
Yeah, I guess I do this first.
Yeah, so you're
straight
gonna
up.
Pick that up very carefully.
Okay.
And then that's actually the front.
Okay.
So we're gonna turn it around.
All right.
Oh yeah.
Like this?
Yeah. Just imagine. Oh. We're at a football
okay.
game.
All right. Oh
yeah,
god.
Then we're gonna rock this
the whole
forward.
Game, right.
My guess is you can figure out from here. You're gonna one, two, three.
Okay.
On the valves. Can you buzz your lips? Can you?
Like a.
Yeah. Like a very fast motor.
I feel like I could pass out.
But it's pretty good though.
Not bad?
No, we could work with that.
My first sousaphone.
Your first, but not your last.
All right.
That's all for Warrior Update. I'm Alenzi France. Thanks for watching. We go behind the scenes to and Jason Stipp tries the tuba. We look behind the...
And it's back.
Dance Friday. Just kidding. It's Friday. Nobody knows or cares about the date anymore. I'm Alenzi France, and this is Warrior Update.